Hydrogen is very important for the energy transition because it gives us the opportunity to reduce our carbon emissions significantly. My name is Christine Heume, and I am a researcher at the research center in Jülich in Germany, where I investigate the degradation of water electrolyzers to improve hydrogen production. So we are investigating the degradation of membrane electrode assemblies. For the production of hydrogen, we just take water and we take electricity, and through a water splitting reaction, we at the end get our hydrogen gas. And this hydrogen can then be used as an energy carrier. The challenges in hydrogen production at the moment are mainly to make the technology efficient and durable for industrial application. So therefore, it's really important that we de-risk this technology. And that is what we do here at the research center.
My name is Eva Jodat. I'm working in the research center Jülich in the Institute of Energy Technologies. Hydrogen is used in lots of kind of our daily life, just like industry. We use it, for example, for the steel production. Our research in Research Center Jülich on hydrogen is very unique because we are going from lab scale, really in situ, in a microscope, up to industrial relevant scale.
ZEISS plays a crucial role in our research. By using, for example, X-ray computed tomography, I can have a non-invasive insight into my sample. And since X-ray computed tomography is non-invasive, I can then take the sample that I investigated and give the sample to colleagues that use other techniques. With scanning electron microscopy, we can further detect structural changes in our material and then hand the material down to other techniques like spectroscopy, for example, the NMR spectroscopy, which then gives us insights into chemical changes. By combining the devices, we were able to detect a structural change in the membrane, which actually then led to a redesign of the electrolyzer component. In the coming years, hydrogen technology will become more popular. It plays a crucial role in the energy transition. In our society, we will most likely see a change in industry, in long-haul transportation or in aviation. As a scientist, you always strive to do better for the world. And what would be better than to combat climate crisis at the moment?